Okay, we are back. So, let's see what we got here. So we still have to go back around to these classrooms all over again. Thank you. It's gonna be hard. So we gotta get... Where is he? Is he back out there? Creepy background noise is creepy. That's what I thought when he said moo. I thought he saw mooey. Okay, he went back out. Where is he? Okay, so there's that. I have no idea. I'm hoping he's way up at the top. I already went into this room on the left. And there was nothing in there except for, like, coins. So I'm just gonna keep... in my ass. Okay. Nope, I don't want to turn that on. I want to shut this off. He's down there. Okay. All right, so... my God. All right, I'm just gonna try to go this way. Away from him. I feel like in this area, I'm not gonna be able to sit around and dilly-daddle like I'm used to. So... he's out of sight. Ooh. Creepiness. Ooh. I got one of those. All right. Nothing. Oh, there's a crane. That paper crane. Okay. So I gotta figure out where he is. Above me? Below me? Next to me? I don't know. He walks super slow and he's not chasing someone. Yeah, precisely. Okay, he's there. Okay, so he can see me. Right. Let's try to go over here. With the static. Okay, so he's going over there. I'm gonna just inch away. Trying to, like, carefully just... Shit! My God. Okay. What was the laugh and the who? Are those two separate things? Wait, what? This is gonna be difficult. I wish there was someone I could hit. Oh, a person, I must hit him. Well, see, Foxy, maybe you should have carried a bat and, like, beat your students up. Agreed, Pumpkin. Agreed. Go away. Go away. Please fucking go away. Foxy's the new janitor. Oh man, a gun in a golf cart? Holy shit. That's awesome. Oh god, I can open while still hiding. That's creepy. he closed this. So he's over there now. So I gotta wait for him to, like, go up or down or something. He's going up. Okay. So he's facing the other way, so maybe I can sneak over to this side and he won't see me. Maybe. No promises. We could sure as hell try. God, I hate how these windows aren't frickin'. These windows are not low enough. It's like they do it on purpose. And it's bullshit. X-ray vision, janitor. That would make sense with this. Is he above me or right next to me? I think I saw his flashlight. He might be on this floor. Now see, this game would be useful if you could make noisemakers and leave them in rooms. Because I could just chuck it in a room, hide somewhere else, lure him into that room. But no. Never go towards the noise. My God. He still sounds so incredibly close. Where is he? What do my tranquilizers do? That's a good question. Eases your mind when you're nervous. Using it will calm you down. Like, when do I ever need that? Like, is it to make all the ghost noises go away? Okay, he's over there. Going down. Like, I don't even see him. He's walking under me. But I don't see him. So, there he is. Maybe the trick is to, like, only walk while he's whistling or something. Maybe I should just focus on getting the key. Maybe that's a good priority. Because I feel like doing anything else is a trap. Or at least get upstairs. And then judge where to go from there. Sounds like he stopped. What's with the noise? So the document about so, it's hanging near the light fixture, but how do I get it? I'm pretty sure I'm where it's hanging. But how do I get it? Get it. It's hanging from the light fixture. How do I get it? You get hurt, really hurt, the main character panics and can die from a heart attack. Really? Huh. Yeah, maybe I do. Alright, well, since I'm up here.
Why? Why?
No, 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 no. no grudge girl shit. Fuck you! Fuck that noise! Okay, she's just in that one, I guess. Seriously, fuck that noise. Okay. Okay. So she's in that one. Up here. She's in 3-8. I'm not doing anything in 3-8. Welcome to hell. Pumpkin thinks she's cool. Oh yeah, she's still here. Does she like come towards me? Oh yeah, she does. Oh fuck no, okay. I was like, maybe she'll just stay on the ceiling, but... nope. So that's part of that same room. Looking for an item. Oh, or a document. Class materials. Oriental studies. Interesting theory of five elements. Teacher vice principal Sang Moon Lee. At the core, the five elements express the concept of the continually repetitive cycle of birth and death. This corresponds to the Buddhist concept of reincarnation. The five elements can be compared to the human life. From an Eastern point of view, a man's death does not end in itself, it begins a new cycle. As the five elements symbolize the grand cycle of everything in the universe, the human life is not limited to the treatment of only the physical layer of existence, body. Following this logic, at times some have expressed a ridiculous notion that the dead can be brought back to life through the theories of the five elements. The idea is that by manipulating the relations of the five elements and running the cycle in reverse order, it can trap the life force enough to cause resurrection. Please take note that this is a dangerous occultist idea created by overanalyzation of the theory of five elements. One should always remember that the cycle is the most important concept in the theory of five elements, and that the proper way of embracing the Oriental teachings is to live according to the natural order of the universe and keeping oneself pure, both in body and mind. Okay. Well, that's a thing. And then I don't think there's anything else here, so... I'm going to close that. So I went there, so I gotta go over here now. No idea where he is. Assuming hanging around downstairs. So does she stay in that room? Nope! She moves around. Great. Awesome. Sweet. So wait. Is she not in that room now? I'm confused. Is there more than one? What the fucking hell? How are you in two rooms? Unless there's more than one of you. What the fuck? Oh, class schedule. Oop. Didn't mean to do that. Okay. Anything else in here? Documents? Papers? Nope. Okay. So that's all good and fine and dandy. Fuck you! I hear him. I don't know where he is, though. Can I go in here? Nope, that's not my color. I have a yellow keycard. Oh, are all these keycards? Oh, shit. I gotta go over here so you don't see me. Okay. So all these are locked up here. So I have three. Might use one. This was a save point up here. Because I don't want to die again and use all this. So there we go. So upstairs is pretty much, okay, so this is where I need to be, but I don't have the key for it. Alright, so upstairs is useless to me. Teleports her as a twin. Yeah, I don't know what happened to her. Which way are you going? That way, of course. Is he gonna go in the one with Grudge Girl in it? He's gonna find the open door? Get eaten by her? Really? Grudge Girl should have ate you! That's bullshit. Okay, so he's crossing the thing. So he should be under me. I guess he is immune to her. Gotta get upstairs. I could do this. I could totally do this. You can't see me. I'm going up here. I don't know what's up here, but I'm going up here. I can't open this door. Oh god. What about this door over here? No? What the fuck? There's a document up here. The mystery in the dance studio. The dance department of Y High School was highly regarded for having produced a number of famous dancers. Many young talents hoping to be a future ballerina competed in Y High School's dance department. Out of these young talents, twin sisters named Ye Yun and Ye Ji, Ye Un and Ye Ji, Spider JK Billy, catch the boy at Janitor. Hey Maria, not yet. appeared the most promising. People speculated that they would grow up to become famous dancers and showered the young sisters with compliments. It was the younger twin, Ye Ji, who received higher praise than her older sister. It was difficult to decide which of the twins was better in terms of physical condition and technique, but it was generally agreed that Ye Ji was better at expressing herself and that she could move people's hearts through her performance. At first, Ye Un didn't give much thought to the reviews. The same review kept repeating, and after losing the lead role to her sister in multiple performances, it began to worry her and she became nervous. In the meantime, the talent show for the school was quickly approaching. The performance from the Y High School's dance department was such a good opportunity to make yourself known to the public, since even the mass media took interest and covered it. Performing the main role in this show would be the equivalent to making a debut in the world of dance. The school decided to hold an audition for the main role to allow a fair selection. It was the day before the audition. Ye Un was pacing back and forth in the dance studio nervously, troubled by her thoughts. She believed that if Ye Ji were to take the leading role from her again this time, she would be doomed to live in Ye Ji's shadow for the rest of her life. After long deliberation, it seemed like she had come to a conclusion. She left the dance studio with an especially shiny pair of ballerina shoes. The next day, there was an accident during the audition. Ye Ji fell during her performance. Her foot was covered in blood, sliced by pieces of broken glass. Her blood stained her ballerina shoes red. In the end, Ye Un was picked to take the leading role. Ye Un performed brilliantly and won the hearts of many fans. The media reports stated that she was the new emerging genius and aired special coverage on her every day. She even received scouting offers from a few famous ballet companies for after her graduation. In contrast, Ye Ji was in complete despair and was slowly withering away. Ye Ji repeatedly tried to practice before her wounds were healed, and it made her injury worse and worse. Eventually, her injury became so terrible that she died of infection. Oh God, that's terrible. When the music stopped, Ye Un took a break from her practice and sat down to wipe the sweat from her face. She was alone in the dance studio after all the other students had gone home. Of course, Ye Ji would be here with her now if she was alive. For a moment she thought about her sister. It gave her goosebumps and she quickly pushed the thought away. She turned the music back on. Ye Un got up and stood in front of the mirror, ready to resume her practice. She stopped when she noticed there was something off with her reflection in the mirror. In the mirror, her ballerina shoes were stained red. Startled, she quickly looked down to check on her shoes, but they were a clean white pair of ballerina shoes. Right at the moment she heard, I've been copying you perfectly so far, sister. Now it's your turn. You copy me now. Ye Un's reflection in the mirror, the one that wore the bloody shoes, raised her hand slowly to grasp her neck. A gleeful grin spread across her face. See, I don't find that scary. I think the twin, who was the better one all along, actually got her revenge for a very mean and rotten sister. So, I mean, good story. Now, where is he? Oh, boy. He's there. I'm gonna move over here. So he's the floor right down from me. I think. I believe so. Okay, so he's there. So I gotta slip down here. Somehow. He is on the same floor, so it's going to be very difficult. Oh, what's this? This is something. Power. Oh, I need... What'd that give power to? No, seriously, what did that give power to? Oh, wait, I'm in the new building. Like, what am I doing here? I don't know. I put power on for something. God, he is... No. No. Like, really? No, no, no. 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 You're chasing me all the way back downstairs, aren't you? I bet you are. Oh, this is fun. Let's go this way. Damn it. God damn, man. He is just as fast as I am. It is really weird. Maybe we could go downstairs. I almost had a heart attack. So, let's, take some stuff to calm me down. Let's take one of these. And then, one of these. There we go. Feel a lot better. in the bathroom while hiding. Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. Look at this nasty ass toilet. It amazes me there's even any room for me to crouch. Let's see. Where is he? No idea. Do you, like, warp to the fucking ceiling or something? I want to try to go downstairs if I can. Maybe. Where did he go? Did I glitch him? Okay. Maybe he couldn't handle the fact that, that I fooled him. Ooh, what's this? An emergency kit? I don't think I've ever picked one of those up yet. Aw, man, I can't even hide under here? That's bullshit. I hear him. I don't see him. Oh shit, I see him. Do-do-do-do-do! You were down there! For some reason. Gotta go, man. Right? It's funny because he's so super sensitive. And he does have eagle vision. But he can't figure out why the same, like, two doors are open. And the same stall in the bathroom is closed all the time. And the rest are open. So, like, it's like he's smart, but he's not. I guess they had to kind of give that for him. Otherwise, it would be impossible to get away from him. But it just amazes me on how sensitive he is, but yet he can't determine I'm hiding in the same area. Just kind of amazes me. I'm not complaining, because I need to hide, but it's just, like, weird. Really bizarre. And how do you get downstairs so quickly? Like, very quickly. Maybe. Be like, fucking spider chick or Mary or whatever the heck Hikaru called her. Like, god damn it, Mary. Stop doing that. Okay. He's on alert for me opening a door. Like, really? Now you're gonna be, like, super creepy sensitive, like, Oh. Jesus. It's... Oh, great, the ghost finally pissed. Let's go check it out. Dear God. This is going to be difficult. Like, really difficult. Four AM. Almost time for school. Oh no, are you kidding me? Jump scare coming. Jump scare coming. Jump scare coming. Jump scare coming. I did not miss you at all. Clock means lunchtime, maybe? Be like, oh, it's time to eat. He didn't close this. Well, that's weird. Am I glitching this janitor the fuck out, or is this supposed to happen? He came out of that door before. Yeah, maybe it was break time for him. Maybe he's just like, oh, damn, we're having a ghost meeting. And I'm not prepared for the ghost meeting. Let's just try to get over here as quickly as we can. What? There's a mirror in here. This room's pretty large and oh, hi. Whoa. Okay. That was a little eerie. Let's just, like, hold out here, cause yeah. Let's just hold out in here. Because I don't know where he is. And I don't want to, like, make noise and trigger where I am. Oh! Shit, is this the, is this that music room from the ghost story? It might be. It might be. Look at me crawl. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh. There is a key card in the mirror. How do I get you? Wait. It's a ref... Oh. Is it like Evil World keycard or something? Oh, there's a thingy here. Shit. Look at me in the mirror. It's pretty amazing. It might be the room. God, that's gonna be a comfortable crouching position to stay in. Well, I could play the CD. I can't move. Uh-oh. What did I do? Whoa! What? Whoa! Whoa! What just... Oh, do I have to reflect it? Oh! Oh, maybe I gotta reflect it. Oh, shit. What the fuck is with this? Oh. Ah. Hang on. What the fuck's happening? I don't even know. What the hell? It's simple. Do I just have to match it? Oh. Ow. Is that it? Oh. Oh yeah, that's what I gotta do. So hang on, cause. What is this music? What the hell? What is this even? So, the back two. There we go. There we go. Fuck you. Oh, that... Yeah. That was kind of okay. Easy-ish. Wait, now I gotta fight him? Shit. Oh, come the fuck on. Really, man? Oh. I gotta get that red key card down there. Got God damn. I really gotta save now. Ding, 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 ding! Pretty much. Like, they didn't even give me, like, a split second to be like, well, fuck. That's better. So, now I gotta go back downstairs and I gotta get the key card. And not die. How many coins did I find? I got 5. So maybe I can, like, check out the vending machine and, like, stock up on some stuff. Since I have all these coins. Maybe. He's leaving the door. Oh, because he's down there. I'm going. He's down there, so. Sorry, no vending machine right now. Just going straight for the key card. Stay up there, dude. Okay. This is very nerve-wracking. So I can go over here now. That's interesting. Alright. Anything else in this giant room? Oh, wait. Okay, so I can't exit or enter this room. At least not on this side, but I can the other side. Go this way. Let's try to save over here. Come on, man. There we go. How? How? You were upstairs. He's gonna turn around and see me. Oh! There's a girl in here. this death. Yep, I'm so glad I saved. I am so glad I saved. I know, I realized that too, and I was like, I don't want to turn it off yet, because if I do, then he might see me. Yeah, yay saving, indeed. Nope. So he comes out of this room. Let's see if we can, like, sneak in here somehow. Might end up running into him face to face, but... I can't go in there. So what's down here? The occult club. Oh, this looks promising. Surely nothing will happen in the occult club. Heaven's Mandate Scroll. As chaos blooms, the rise of the sun and moon will become different for each country, and panic will ensue. In the midst of all this, a true man shall come forth to set each time under a single standard. Only then will the dark river be crossed and the sacred object be attained. Okay. Pillows everywhere. Nameless document. There used to be a pond at the spot before the new building was built. Of course, there were rumors that the pond was haunted. According to local legend, it was cursed pond. And the souls of the people who drowned in that pond were trapped in it. The only way an imprisoned soul can escape the pond was to drag another soul into that pond. That's why the ghosts of the pond were more bloodthirsty, killing more people. And it's worst. The pond claimed a life every month. The school warned the students about the pond, but the drownings did not stop. Some people wanted to fill in the pond, but the chairman always decided against it. The chairman said that the pond allowed to flow well. I mean, how important is feng shui when people are dying, you know? Well, I later found out just how important feng shui is. Anyways, because of the fierce protests, it was finally decided that the pond was to be filled in. But on the first day of filling in the pond, the machine operator died of a heart attack. After that, the school had to hold a purification ritual every year for the pond. Time passed and the new building was built over the spot where the pond used to be. No more rituals. Lately, though, there are rumors that ghosts are showing up again. Just rumors. Just rumors. They say that a girl's ghost drenched in water wearing an old school uniform that can only be seen in the history room is being spotted. Was that the girl that we saw walking out of the room with Jay Young or whatever the heck her name was? The creepy one that was locked in the closet with her? Right? What isn't haunted in this school? She's got to be one of the ghosts of a student that died in the pond. You might ask why a pond ghost would appear when the pond is gone. Well, it's hard to explain, but this world and the underworld exists in the same space. What does that mean? It means that humans and ghosts occupy the same space, but in different, for lack of a better word, dimensions. You could also compare it to radios, each of them giving off its own frequency, and that's why humans and ghosts cannot influence each other. So even if there is a building built over where the pond was in the world, that pond could still be there in the underworld's dimension. I will try to find out the truth of all this today. I was finally able to create the occult club. The teachers hate it. They say I'm wasting my precious youth. Even though people find my club weird, my club is not a joke. We investigate and research the supernatural phenomena that cannot be explained by modern science. Naturally, the quickest way of proving our worthy cause would be finding a ghost. Just by sheer luck, I've recently come upon something called Elrod, which has magical powers. It doesn't, honestly, no. The person who found it told me that they can detect ghosts, as well as be used as dowsing rods. They don't have magical powers, but they are supposed to detect where a ghost's presence is. Okay, then. What is this? I want to believe! Investigation of the Yin-Yang Token 1. Love Rod? Did I say Love Rod? Did I actually say that? I don't get it. The yin-yang token is a mirror used in Taoism that has bronze mirror in the center. It has the power to chase away evil and illuminate the truth. The yin-yang token is octagonal and inscribed with the 8 trigrams, a mirror in the center and the yin-yang symbol on the backside. It is sometimes used in movies. When energy is instilled in the token, it can unleash the power, chase away, or destroy evil. However, it is also said that simply reflecting light off the bronze mirror can yield the same effect. Our school has an yin-yang token on display in the history room. Cool, I guess? Oh, there's another thingy here. I wonder if these serve something. Pentagon in Washington, D.C. And another clock. Can I move this one? Yeah. Weird. Okay. I have no idea where he is now. Trying to be cautious. Oh. Let us grab some of these. We had a bunch of them. And then let's try. Some of these. To replenish the one that we used. I think that's it. Yeah, I don't have any more coins. Okay. Oh, look at that. Another coin. Oh, wait, nope. Oh, this is like a cafeteria area? I guess? The electrical room. Hmm. Very weird. That's a blue card. I need a red card. I have a red card. I don't know where he is. But red unlocks everything on the upper floor. So, I guess I gotta go up. Whoa! What is going on? What the fuck is happening? What? What was that? You very much heard this, did you not? I hear whispering. And the whispering stopped. Someone being dragged? It sounded like someone was pushing a bunch of desks around. Like when you get really lazy and you don't want to empty out your desk at school and then you just like drag it across the linoleum floor. That's what it sounded like. No idea. I don't even know where the janitor is. Yeah, no, I don't know. This room's huge. Really huge. I'm gonna try to go under the assumption that I'm okay for now. Come on. Oh! A key! Small yellow key. Can be combined with other keys. Hmm. Interesting. So are we in the library? We're in a reading room. Oh god, where is she? Nope. 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 No jump scares, please. No jump scares, please. No jump scares, please. No jump scares. I'm gonna read. I'm gonna read. You can't jump scare me if I'm reading. Whew. The meaning of the labyrinth. About labyrinths, during the times of ancient Greece, the word labyrinth referred to an underground building that was designed to be a maze. Labyrinths are later seen as high-fenced gardens during the Renaissance age. The four great labyrinths of the world are the Egyptian labyrinth, the Cretan labyrinth, the Lemnos labyrinth, and the Italian labyrinth. It might happen when we're done, so I don't know. Just kind of prepare yourselves. There are two kinds of labyrinths. The first is designed so that all paths lead to the center. In this type of labyrinth, the same path will not be taken twice, but one must take longest distance possible to reach the destination. In the second kind, the paths are forked and very complicated, making it very easy to get lost. To deal with this type of labyrinth, one must rely on memory and good judgment. The labyrinth symbolizes many different meanings, and its symbol and appearance changes depending on the era and region. A traditional meaning of the labyrinth signifies exclusion and imprisonment, allowing only those who are worthy to find the exit. Getting to the center of the labyrinth symbolizes uterine regression, and the labyrinth represents the body of Mother Earth. Thus, it is the women who own and control the labyrinth, while men must find the right path to escape. The continuity of the labyrinth signifies immortality and eternity, and in the Eastern philosophy, it means to escape the cycle of birth and death and the rules of karma. In the perspective of a funeral rite, the labyrinth symbolizes death and resurrection. Going into the labyrinth means death, and coming out of it means resurrection. So in a way, the labyrinth can be thought of as a model underworld. And Foxy's fled the battle. Alright, and jump scare? Oh yeah. It's just gonna happen. Let's just do it. Get rid of it. Just... Thanks. Thanks. Thanks for visiting. Okay. Oh, what's that? Tranquilizer. There's no book here. Why is this relevant? Like, why? That's weird. It's a giant reading room. So, oh, is this the thing she was telling me about? No idea. But now I gotta walk all the way around. The Reading Rainbow Room. Hell yeah. Okay, so that's all unlocked now. I wonder if the noise we heard was the janitor glitching. Wouldn't that be great? Got in here. We have another pin. I don't know what they're used for. None of these computers are. Wait, are they plugged in? Is that a hole in the desk? It might be a hole in the desk. Nothing there. Looks like there's just a globe in here and that's it. I'm just like looking. Oh, there's another one. Just like hitting A and there's another one. I don't know what this does, but what does that do? They don't stay. That's strange. Alright, so I guess I need more pins? I don't know. Are these locked in place? Why would you do that? Are you afraid someone's going to steal all the computers? Maybe I didn't? I don't know. I'm waiting for, like, the grudge girl to be in one of these rooms. Oh. Oh! Was I supposed to do that? Where is that? Oh, in this room. Library rules plaque. The rules for the library. It's a laminate coating makes it ideal for shoving between gaps. Oh. Okay. Great, now he's up here. Really? Because I made progress, he returns. So dumb. Exactly. Yay for making progress and not knowing how. Well, I kind of guessed on that power thing that I didn't want to set off the security alarm, and it was already on lights, so I figured it just needed to be on power for something. I smell progress. Dude, go the fuck away. I don't know where you are, but go the fuck away. Like, if I go into this room here, he's going to know I'm here. Like, indefinitely. That's why I'm waiting for him to go away. Like, you can't see me behind here. He's really next to the door, too. Come on, dude. Go away. Go away. I smell Grudge Girl downstairs. You can just go have a quickie. I won't tell anyone. Like, I'll be in there. It's like you never even saw me. Never even heard me. It's all good. Like, no, he's just gonna linger on this side. He's just gonna linger. Linger, linger, linger. Yeah, I don't believe you, game. He's still pretty frickin' close. I want confirmation that that whistling is really far away from me. Good enough. Oh! That's what I had- okay. Sweet. There's no windows in here. So I can walk around? Maybe? There she is!
I'm just so tired of this. I'm terrified. I just don't understand why all this happened. We'll never get out of here. We're all going to die.
There, there. Have some faith.
Do you really think you can?
I have to, it's the game.
Just stay back!
No!
Don't come near me. Just, oh, please, leave me alone.
Why?
Everyone's acting so strange tonight. Like they've all lost their minds.
Including you.
When I was walking with Soyoung earlier, Sung-hyuk came up to us. But Soyoung just ignored Sung-ha and kept walking. Sung-ha got angry and started following Soyoung and yelling. I got so scared. Usually, Songa and Soyoung spend a lot of time off together. And when Songa talks, Soyoung usually just listens to her. I've never seen them fight like they did earlier. I've never seen them act like that before. I feel like something really bad's about to happen. I think that it was one of them who locked us in here. Maybe.
What happened? How? I was right in front of her. How does that fucking happen? Like, really? How does it just vanish? Ooh. I got the token. There's a document. Investigation on the yin-yang token. More investigation is needed to confirm what actually happened, but I was locked in the dark due to the power outage in the music appreciation room when I started to lose my sense of direction and began to feel a short of chill. A short of chill? Not a sort of chill? I observed a bright light emitting from the bag with the yin-yang token in it. I might have been seeing things from focusing too hard on the investigation, but it was nonetheless a magical experience. Okay. Okay, so. He's nearby-ish. While I doubt he can see me, I'm sure he can hear me. So. Yeah, he's, So, we have... We have the token. It gives off a lucky vibe. So that's the token to get out of here, correct? But... I don't think that helps us with getting to the pool. Or do we have to use that for something else? I'm very confused. Very, very confused. Okay, so he's nearby somewhere. Why is the eye appearing and, like, disappearing and reappearing? That's not fair. But the stairs are right here. So that's a good sign. So the second floor is where the door is. So I gotta make it to the second floor? I guess? Somehow? Above me? Below me? He's below me. He's below me. Okay. So he's below me. Thank you. Oh boy. He's right there. I need to figure out which way he's going. So I gotta go down? He doesn't see me. That's it. You keep on whistling, buddy. Keep on the whistling. Now go the opposite way. Turn right. Of course you're going this way. Fuck. I gotta go past you, so deal with it. Okay. Oh, man. Oh, boy. Ah, jeez. Man. I'm not here. I'm not here. Well, at least it made getting down easier. Before I go check out the music girl, I'm going to save, because there's a save point down there. Okay. We're gonna heal. Okay. There we go. Time to quietly eat on the toilet. Okay. Tacos. Oh man, I wish I had tacos. I love tacos. Okay. So as soon as this guy leaves, everybody gets tacos. Taco for everybody. Now the question is he really, really gone? Or is he kind of, sort of, maybe, but not really gone? He sounds far away. Okay, he actually left. So, he's upstairs.